Hello everyone, welcome to my crab soup cooking tutorial. As always, start out with some clean wash hands. For your ingredients, we're going to have some imitation crab meat. If you have the real crab meat, then it would be even better. Some fresh ground chicken. Peas and carrots are optional. Going to have some chicken broth or chicken stock and firm tauhu. Prep up your crab sticks by cutting them into threes. Next, we want to go ahead and separate all of this crab meat. As you can see, it's very easily smushed. You don't actually have to use a knife to separate these pieces. We want everybody to be able to get these bite size. I forgot to show you that we also need 4 eggs. We're just getting the white part. You could keep the yolk for something else like fried rice or something. Never waste food. You could either use the shells to pull out the white part or, like me, just use my hands. And like I said, I always stay next to the sink so I could wash my hands in between because I hate getting my hands dirty. For the firm tauhu, we're gonna cube them up very small. In the meanwhile, boil the ground chicken in a small pot. Not thoroughly cooked, but just enough to get some of that grime away. And here with some hot boiling water, we're going to add our chicken broth. Once it's boiled, after you drain that chicken, go ahead and add that meat in. Stir them to make sure that the meat are separated. Add in the rest of your crab meat. And like I said, if you have the real crab meat, then this dish would make it way better. Or if you could just use chicken stock for all of your soup, it's really tasty. Add in probably 2 tablespoons of black pepper. We want to put 1.5 tablespoon of salt. I'm putting 2 tablespoons of rice vinegar. And put 1 tablespoon of sesame oil. Add in your tauhu. And go ahead and add in 1/2 cup of those peas and carrots. And like I said, this part is very optional. If you put too much, it's really overbearing. Give it a quick stir. Once it's boiled, add in your cornstarch mixture. This is 9 teaspoons of cornstarch with 1/2 cup of water because you want the soup to be really condensed. If you feel that it's not enough, add more cornstarch. We have to make the soup thick. Once it thickens up, go ahead and spoon some of that white eggs. Because we want little pieces of it just where the boiling part is. As you could see, we could see pieces of the white part of the eggs. I made this soup at my Memorial Day party, so I'm placing it in a crock pot. This is a very neat, quick way to just serve people as an appetizer. And I'm sorry I'm gonna have to use my disposable plate to show you here because I'm fixing to eat it along with all my other disposable plates for other foods. I hope you enjoy. Thank you for watching.